As the NBA season is coming to a close, a lot of things have revealed themselves, whether that's about players or teams. We have a good idea what teams have a bright future and what teams don't have a bright future. And one of those teams that doesn't just have no bright future, I would say they have the worst future in the NBA, is the Brooklyn Nets. Now, let's rewind back to February last year. The Nets traded Kyrie to the Mavericks, then a couple of days after that, they traded KD to the Suns. In total, the Nets got in return was Mikal Bridges, Cam Johnson, Spencer Dinwiddie, Dorian Finney-Smith. 5 first-round picks, 2 second-round picks, and a pick swap, with all the picks going over the span from last year to the year 2029. After trading KD and Kyrie, it was no surprise the Nets became a worse team. After the trade deadline, the Nets had a record of 13-15, which was the 20th best record in the NBA, showing they were a below average team. Despite that, they still made the playoffs as the 6th seed in the East, where, no shocker, they got swept by the Sixers. Even though they got swept, their future didn't look horrible. After coming to the Nets, Mikal Bridges was playing incredible, averaging 26 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists on 47-37 shooting splits. Him averaging 26 points per game was basically a 9-point increase from what he was averaging on the Suns. During this stretch, it looked like Mikal Bridges made a leap. As a result, this made his trade value skyrocket. There was a couple of teams willing to give up multiple draft picks for Bridges, some even willing to trade 4 first round picks this past offseason. Those teams included the Pelicans, Grizzlies, and the Rockets. The Rockets, in particular, were willing to trade Jalen Green and send back several of the Nets' first round picks from the James Harden trade. And guess what Sean Marks did? He declined that trade. Now we are at the beginning of this season. The Nets come in with basically the same roster, and Sean Marks really believed they could be a decent team. He had no idea what was in store for this team. In the first 28 games of this season, the Nets had a record of 13-15. Surely they didn't have the same record after the trade deadline last year, showing this roster was destined to be a below average team. Oh wait. They did. And things got worse from December 27th to February 8th, which is the trade deadline. They had a record of 5-16, which was the third worst record in the NBA in this span. This being the case, the Nets should have blown it up at the deadline. Trade Mikal Bridges, trade Nick Claxton, one of the best defensive centers in the NBA. Not to mention, he is on the last year of his contract. The Nets could have got a first round pick for him. Trade Dorian Finney-Smith, Royce O'Neal, and Spencer Dinwiddie. They did trade Royce O'Neal to the Suns for some second round picks. They traded Spencer Dinwiddie to the Raptors for Dennis Schroeder. That's certainly a trade. And that was it. Sean Marks had 2 chances to make the choice and blow it up, fully committing to a rebuild. He said, nah, we good. Let's just say that was the wrong decision. On February 19th, they fired Jacques Vaughn after just last year signing him to a contract extension. They would hire Kevin Ollie, who is an assistant coach, to be the interim head coach. Ben Simmons, after the trade deadline, would only play 5 games before being ruled out for the season because of back issues. Since Kevin Ollie has been the head coach, nothing has changed for the Nets. They have a record of 11-16, which is the 9th worst record in the NBA. Now, here we are in present day. The Nets are the 11th seed in the East with no shot at making the play-in. Their roster is the definition of mid, and now they go in the offseason having to hire a new head coach. They have a slim chance of re-signing Nick Claxton. I expect him to sign with a playoff team or contender this offseason. Ben Simmons is now one of, if not the worst contract in the NBA. Mikal Bridges has regressed severely this season, and his trade value has fallen off a cliff compared to this past offseason. Now, the guy who at one point had teams willing to trade 4 first-round picks for him, that is no longer happening. And the Nets don't have a first-round pick of their own until 2020. 28, but Sean Marks has no one to blame for the position the Nets are in besides himself. I appreciate you watching this video. Let me know in the comments, do you think the Nets have the worst future in the NBA? See y'all in the next one.